Hey everyone, welcome back to my Dev Web App channel. Today I'm going to build a crypto prices app with HTML, CSS, JavaScript and Axios. I'll show you how to set up project with Vite and add Axios package to it. Let's take a look at the design. As you can see, I have a header and a table with cryptocurrency prices. The table has columns for rank, name, symbol, price in USD and a change for 24 hours. And also I have values, I have 100 coins, and the data is coming from a CoinCap API, and I used this endpoint for my GET request. Let's go to the code and build our application. I launched my Visual Studio Code and open folder for my JavaScript HTML CSS projects, and now I'm going to run new terminal and run command npm create vite app latest. And I need to provide project name and it will be crypto prices. And now I'm going to select vanilla and JavaScript. And I can navigate to my folder with cd command and install dependencies. And also I'm going to add Axios to project, and I'll copy this command npm install Axios and will provide it to my terminal. And now I can run dev server with command npm run dev and open my application in browser. Okay, and we have Vite and JavaScript. And now I can open my project and I have index.html file and also I have main JavaScript, and I'm going to remove all code from main JavaScript. And inside index.html, I'm going to change the name to crypto prices. And also, we'll add a link to styles and provide style CSS. And let's go to style CSS and remove some styles like for button, card, for logo. Okay, then I can hide terminal and also from media queries, and I will remove for h1 and also for links. Okay, and let's check what we have, and we have empty screen, and let me add some h1 H2 tag like crypto prices. Let's check again. And we have our header here. And for building my JavaScript application, I'm going to reuse the code from my React project that I built recently. And you can check the video about it. But I'll just copy paste data, and I'll just copy this JSX and will paste it into my HTML file. And I need to remove this code for table body. And let's check what we have so far. Okay, and we have our header, and also we have this table headers. And now I'm going to add code to main JavaScript, and I'll also copy the code from my React project, and I will explain it later. And let me just copy this code and provide it to my main JavaScript file. And let's see what we have here. And actually, I need also import Axios. And we'll add it here. Okay, and let's check what we have inside. We have a fetch and data function, and then we have try catch blocks. And here I'm making Axios GET request to CoinCap API to that endpoint, and then wait for result and save the response to result variable, and then make console log. Let's comment out this set cryptos, and catch block contains just console error. And then we need to call page data function. And let's check what we have. I'm going to open developer tools and open console and refresh the page. And as you can see, we have data in response, and inside data we have data and object of coins with data. And now we can build our table. We added some code, and let's check what we have inside that index.html. We have this container, and also we have header, and also we have a table with a table header. And I added one table row and with actual table headers. And also we have table body. And now I'm going to add values from the API to my table body. And for that, I'll use function set cryptos. And I will provide the code. And let me add function set cryptos. And I need some cryptos. It will be array of objects, and I will pass it as a parameter to my set cryptos function. And now we can iterate through our cryptos and using for each. Okay, for each. And now I can copy paste my code from React application, and we'll modify it a bit. Okay, I'm going to take this code and provide it here. And in JavaScript, we don't have JSX, and I need to use the template string. Okay, and we'll use it here. And I need to add it here. Okay, and now I need to provide my variables inside template string. And I will use the same variables as in my React app. And for each crypto, I'm going to return a table row with table data. And I need to save this row into some variable, and let me add some variable at name new.yml. And initially it will be empty string, and I'm going to add this table row to my new.html, and we'll add it for each crypto inside cryptos array. And now I'm going to add my inner HTML to my actual table body. And for that, I'm going to use document element, and we'll use function method getElementById. And I need to provide ID to my HTML element, and let's add ID table body. Okay, and now I can use this name, and we'll add in your HTML and provide value of my local variable. And let's check what I have so far. I'm going to refresh the page, and as you can see, we have values inside our table, and we have values in console, and also we can check network and what we have in response, but we have the same data as in console and also as in our table. And now I can provide some styles, and the styles I'm going to take also from my React application. Okay, and I'll provide the styles just inside my style. I have only one table, and let's check. And as you can see, we have the separator here, and the styles were applied. Let me refresh the page, and now I can see all data that I retrieved from API in my table. And that's all that I had for today. If you like the video, subscribe to my DevWebApp channel. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.